Alright, hold on. Hold on. Hold on. Hold on.
Hope you guys. 10 Now in the back, I'm going to take a bit of a triangle or a diamond shaped section, is actually what it is. And this is going to be sort of like a swing layer or like a cascading layer that's gonna be able to move over the whole back section and create a lot of flow. So I'm just gonna section this out. Be able to move back and forth, side to side, and still have some coverage. Naturally, hair tends to be a little bit deeper in here, and as I'm going for a very lived-in, sun-kissed look, with the balayage painting, we're going to get a little bit less lift than you would in foil, but it's going to create like a really soft, gentle dimension in the inside of the hair. So this is going to be done in four sections. Make sure that my sectioning, subsectioning here is nice and smooth. And if you're ever dealing with a bit of like frizziness in the hair You can also use a prostate equalizer or a leave-in spray conditioner just to help smooth those little baby hairs down if they're getting in your way. So for this technique, I have switched to a balayage lightener specifically for open air. The reasoning behind that is so that it can just lay, be natural. I don't have to enclose it in anything because it creates its own shell and just keeps working underneath that. If you're going for a lot more lift, you might want to enclose in foil or in plastic. But for this, we're going to keep it nice and subtle, so it's not necessary. So I've started with a little bit of product on my brush, and I'm staying away from the root. I'm not going to apply here first, because if I apply here first, it's going to be a lot of product, and we're going to get too much lift. So I'm going to start about halfway down.
Okay.
And then I'm just slowly working the product gently up towards the scalp. So I'm going to be painting in V's, because this is going to give me a little bit more dimension and a really soft look. Notice how I'm keeping this section elevated and I'm not pulling it down, because I don't want to saturate through to the hairs underneath. So I'm keeping this really taut. And just little bits of product at a time. You want to build it up slowly. Less is more. So now that I'm happy with the way my V's look here, I'm going to start to saturate through here. Still keeping really good tension and just slowly sliding my hands down, watching my elevation. Product, I'm going to get more lift. So I'm just always checking in and seeing, is that enough? Do I need to add a little bit more? This feels like it looks pretty good to me. So as I get down to the bottom here, I've started to lower my elevation here. And just gently ending like that. You can also check to make sure how the underside looks, and notice that we haven't bled through at all. And then making sure that I'm always cleaning my hands off as much as I can in between, and the brush if I need to. The more clean everything is that you're working, the more clean the outcome is going to be. So again, I'm just going to use a little of this porosity spray just to tame down those little hairs. All right, again, nice even tension. I'm not going to hold my hair all the way down here if I'm applying up here, because this means this is not going to be as taut here. So when I'm working up here, I want to hold my fingers, pinch this close, and keep this tension really nice and tight. So again, starting away from the scalp, and slowly feathering this up, using almost a circular motion. Little bits of product at a time. Thank you. And then to the other side here, adding my V in. Little flicks of the wrist. And then now we're going to start fully saturating. So just slowly moving my hand down while I'm applying the product. And if you notice here, my saturation has gone a little bit lower just to keep with this line in through here so that we have really good flow. Underneath. Good, nice and clean, no saturating through. And then all the way to the bottom. And I'm just going to tuck these hairs underneath here just with the end of my brush, just to make sure this is laying nice and smooth. So once we've completed this back section here, we have four subsections working through the back. I've now taken a horizontal parting that's going from basically the middle of our outside subsections straight across. Use a little more porosity spray. So I'm gonna divide this into two subsections here just for control. You absolutely can do it in one. I'm choosing to do it in two for control, and also because I am trying to create quite a lot of dimension in through here. So I almost want like a few more balayage pieces. So same as before, nice, tight, even tension. Starting away from the scalp. Feathering up. I'm keeping these, this painting that's on the edge, nice and soft, because I don't want a bold, thick line coming down through the hair. You absolutely can have that if that's the look that you're going for, but for this I'm trying to keep it very soft and natural. So I'm putting less product on the edges. And then I'm just gonna check and see where I want my light line to start, where my saturation is. Load up with more product, and this is where I'm gonna start saturating heavily through here. Light pressure. Nice circular movement with my brush. I'm also trying to make sure that I'm keeping a diagonal line in with my painting to avoid any horizontal lines. Horizontal lines tend to be a bit more harsh, and with a diagonal line, you're going to have a lot more softness. Again, I'm just going to check and see how that feels. That's pretty good to me. And you'll notice I'm not adding balayage on the inside here, because these two sections are going to come together in the back, and if I add in through here, that's going to create a bit more of a bold effect in here, which I'm not looking for. We're going for extreme softness. So again, just watching my elevation, and as I come through the ends, then I can start to pull this down here. And then just before I let go, I'm just going to check, make sure the underside is nice and clean. That here. looking up our other subsection. Again, minimal product. Move my fingers up a little bit closer so I can make sure I'm maintaining even tension here. Gently feathering the product up. Now I'm going to check where my light line is again. To my brush. So we're about right. So here I'm going to slide my fingers down, add more product, and then just checking to make sure I've still got like a nice angle in through there. We don't have any straight horizontal lines. Looks good. Pulling back out. I notice when I'm releasing this, I'm trying to keep my fingers at the exact same spot, so when I pull this back up, we've got that tension back where we need it. Again, load up on product, smooth this on. And start to bring my elevation down as I get through the ends. Just checking, good. There, now you can see that these two sections are going to meet together perfectly in the middle here. Okay, for my final subsection with the balayage, we've released this here. And I'm going to take four sections. But what's going to be different about these four from the previous four sections that I did is I'm just going to paint only one side of this subsection. As we get closer to the top, I want to make sure that I have lots and lots of softness in here. And as these subsections are smaller, I don't want to overload them with too much. Just like before, nice light product, really smoothing it on very gently. Checking where my light line is going to be, where do I want this saturation to start? This with the other three subsections. Now moving on to our diamond shape through the top here. We talked about earlier, this is like our swing piece, our cascading piece. I'm gonna switch to back to foliage and some TZ lights like we did in the nape section, just because I want a more melty effect. I'm very super blended, a little bit more refined. I like this sun-kissed look underneath here, but I want just a little bit more in through here. So I'm going to approach this at a diagonal, and doing this diagonally is just going to keep lots of softness and avoiding all horizontal lines. I'm going to take my first subsection here. I'm take a nice, fine baby light weave here. So you can see this is just going to give us like a nice, gentle, sparkly effect. I switched to 20 volume with lightener for the top. This is our last section, so it's going to be on a little bit less than the bottom. So starting through the mids, I'm applying. Turning my brush on the angle here to sweep this through. Making sure to fully saturate. And then same with as we did in the nape section, we're just going to bring this up and tap this through here. Just going to give us a really soft, feathered appearance near the scalp. So this way, when it grows out, it maintains its softness for a really long time. Now through here, I've got a lot of lightness in the ends here, so I don't want this to be fully saturated with lightener, but I am pulling the ends up here just to check. You can see in through here, it just needs a little more lift. So just being really mindful of the integrity of the ends of her hair. Folding this up. I'm gonna lock this in. Now I'm gonna take another parting about an inch from the previous section. I'm not trying to overload her with highlights, so we're leaving a lot of dimension in between. Take her subsection here, weave this out. Nice little baby lights. Again, starting from the mids, saturating through the ends. Lightly feathering up through the top. Making sure to keep my brush vertical so we don't accidentally put any horizontal lines in. Checking the ends here where we need to add a little bit of product. But not fully saturating those very blonde ends. Now what I'm going to do here, so I'm just going to clip this one up out of the way. And this hair that's in between here, we're going to do a teasy light. So I'm just going to do a light back comb. And then just weaving out a little bit more extra hair.
Keep doing it.
Now what this is doing, this is basically creating like a sandwich of some highlight. So we have ones that come up a little bit further and ones that start out a little bit further. So we create lots of different levels of dimension and lots of softness. All our stuff going on here. Now we're moving on to the side. So the side we've separated into two. This is from the round of the head. This is getting clipped up and away. And what we're going to do in through here is similar to what we've been doing in the back. We're going to do a little bit of teasy lights with some foliage and a little bit of balayage. So around her face, I'm going to do a little bit of foliage. So I'm just weaving out this section really fine so that when we pull this up, we can see this is going to be really soft dimension around her face. I'm sticking with 20 ball right now because this section is a lot smaller and quicker to move through than the back, so it's not going to be sitting on for a super long time. So I'm applying away from the scalp. And then this, I'm going to just use my brush to back feather this up. So I'm not moving this hair around too much. It's pretty fine and delicate, and I don't want to pull it off at all, so I'm just being really gentle with all of it. And not pulling through the previously lightened hair, especially around her face. That hair is a lot more delicate. We want to be as gentle and nice to it as possible. So we're going to go back to back with this one. I do want to create some brightness around her face, a fair bit of it. So make sure we've got a nice clean section here. I'm going in at an angle like this because this is going to mimic her hairline the best. So as it grows in, it's going to stay really soft. When it's down, it has a nice soft flow to it. Nice micro even through here. Just tapping this gently, just make sure this is really smooth here. And then for this next section that I'm going to do, you can see it's going to start to line up with her nape area back here. So I'm going to do a bit of a teasy leg in through here. I don't feel like with this section I want it to come all the way up to the scalp, as we have these three back-to-back little foliage baby lights in through here. So for this section here, I'm going to have a like, nice light back home. This is now kind of like a bigger weave. These are going to feel a bit more ribbony, but again, this section is so small and fine. It's not going to have a heavy effect. Find my product, keeping my brush vertical. Here, I'm going to switch to balayage. So we have this nice brightness around here that's going to fade into like a little bit more soft in through here. So I'm going to divide this into two. Still with diagonal angles, so we're keeping lots of softness. Starting with a little bit of product. And I'm watching like where this hair is going to lay. So this is going to lay down this way, so I want to be mindful of how I'm applying product. Where it's going to be sitting. So I'm going to apply to the top surface of this section. Pulling this out, really even tension. So my light lines here, and then this is where I start saturating a little. Delicately working in this product.
You're like, oh, we lost our heart, like, we have the back, and it's like, no.
Just checking to see how it's going to lay and where my lightness is coming from. Checking the underneath. And same for my next section. A little bit of product. Make sure my tension is even.
Thank you.
section here. This is going to be very similar to the side section. So we're going to start with some baby lights right around her hairline. So when she wears her hair up, she's got some brightness there. Switching back to my lightener with 20 volume. I'm going to feather this one here pretty close to the root, just because that's that money piece and you want a little pop there. Not overloading with too much product, because this is a finer section. We don't want it to weigh itself down at all. Watching those previously lightened ends. Saturating through. So now we have our baby lights and teasy light section. So I'm going to continue on, similar to what we've done in the back here. A solid look. We want to make sure that we're leaving some dimension. You can see inch room here. We have about, this is about half an inch or so. So we're going to do about the same here. Nice fun. Baby light leaves. Starting from the mids, feathering this up, saturating for the ends. Now I'm going to clip this out of the way, pull up this section in between.
Yes.
Give it a gentle back comb. Place this underneath. So this is going to start a little further out. So I'm starting in the mids and applying, and then just lightly feathering up. Again, we don't want to lose all of the dimension at the root. We want to keep that nice and soft. So we're just creating just various levels of lightness. Watching those ends. And there you have that sandwich, and we're just going to continue this through the rest of the section. So now we've completed the last side in the same manner that we've done the other side. So we've added baby lights and foliage around her hairline with some balayage painting through the interior. And then done the same thing with the top here. So we've done a nice bright money piece in the front. We've moved into some foliage and teasy lights through the back here. So we'll have like a nice, soft, beautiful, bright transition. And then we're just gonna leave her to process. And what I like to do for this is just stick a little pin curl clip in here. And that just leaves her a little bit more comfortable while she's sitting here in process. All right, so now it's time for us to glaze. We've shampooed her out, a light condition. I like to do that just to even out porosity and make it easier to comb through the hair. For her glaze, we are going to be using a demi-permanent color. I'm using Shades EQ. I like it because it's more of a sheer finish and leaves the hair in like a really, really nice condition. She's a natural level 7. So for her root glaze, I'm going to be using an 8, which putting on damp hair will dilute it just a little bit more than that. And I feel like that's going to give us a nice transition between the lightness that we've put in and her natural base color. And as the hair grows out and it sort of like rinses off over time, it'll just keep like a really smooth effect. So we're going to start in the back here. So I've got my level 8N is what I'm using. It's a good balance between cool and warm, so it'll give us a really nice finish. So I'm going to tap this color in and bring this down to the hairline here. As I'm moving up the head, I'm almost going to use that first application as a stationary guideline for this glaze. So I'm going to bring this root down to the same spot. And notice I'm keeping everything at the diagonal, because again, that's going to give us really smooth lines and keep us from having anything too harsh and horizontal. And then every few sections, I can just comb this through. Thank you. And then once I get up to the rounds of the head here, I'm not gonna bring this as far down. I'm gonna bring it just below the round here. So I don't want all of these highlights to disappear. So again, just tapping it in. Just bringing it down just below the round. That I'm going to leave out this bright money piece that we've put in. So I'm going to section this top part out. Down to the ear. What we've done in the back, I'm going to bring this to just below the rounds. So this is going to match up with how where I've brought the glaze here, and then I'm just going to bring it up in just a slight angle towards the front. So below the rounds, and then just tapping it up. Almost like in a teardrop. Bring that a comb through. Any of the brightness that we've created. And for the ends, I've mixed a 9NB with 9V. So we're going to have a nice cool finish, but not ashy. And then I'm just gonna take these in bigger sections, apply with a bottle, quite quick. This through really well. And I like to use a wet brush. This one's the Tangle Teaser. Just comb this through really well. Make sure I'm getting a really good blend between the root shadow and our end glaze. For our last section here. front hairline out until I finish applying to the other side. It's finer and lighter, so it's going to absorb the glaze quite quickly. So we'll work all this through. I'll apply to the other side, and then for the last few minutes, we'll apply to the hairline.
Alright, hold on, everybody. Hold together. 10 seconds. Thank you.